Now, one way to stitch a bunch of photographs together is to go up to the file menu, choose automate, and then choose this guy right here, photo merge. And then notice that initially we don't actually have any files to work from. And so to load up the base photos, you need to click on the browse button and then click on one and shift click on the last one like so, and then click OK in order to load up a list of all of those files. And then I'd click OK inside of this dialog box in order to let her rip. However, I'm going to show you my preferred way of working by canceling out here, and then I'll go up to the file menu and choose Browse and Bridge, which will go ahead and launch the independent Adobe Bridge application, assuming that you've installed it. All right, now here we're seeing all those quarter-sized JPEG files, and so notice that each one of them measures 1,824 pixels wide by 2,736 tall. If you want to work from those original DNG files, then go up to the View menu and turn on Show Folders, if it's not already on, so that you can see this subfolder right here. These are the original DNGs. I'll just go ahead and double-click on that folder, and you can see that these files are twice as large in each direction. So in other words, they measure 3,648 pixels wide by 5,472 pixels tall. One other thing I want you to see here, I'm going to go ahead and click on one of these thumbnails and then right-click and choose Open in Camera Raw, or you can press Control-R or Command-R on the Mac. And notice that I've applied a few modifications over here in the Basic panel. More importantly, however, if I switch over to the Lens Corrections panel, I've turned on both of these checkboxes. And so, in other words, I've gotten rid of the geometric lens distortion, and I've also gotten rid of any vignetting. And assuming that you're shooting RAW, I recommend that you turn on both of these checkboxes for every image that you're going to be working with before you apply the photo merge command. All right, so I'll just go ahead and cancel out here. I am not going to be working with these big DNG files, and so I'll switch back to the Arches folder right there, and I'll go up to the View menu and choose Show Folders to turn it off, and that way we can focus on the images themselves. All right, so when you're shooting these photographs, what you want to do is face straight forward at the center of your scene, as we're seeing here. And so I just selected that center image, and I press the space bar to enter the full screen preview mode. And you want to establish your focus and exposure and lock things down. Now, it's great if you have a tripod, but it's not necessary. I did not have a tripod on me in this case. In which case, just face forward, so plant your feet, and then twist your body all the way over to the right-hand side, or you can start on the left if you like. And notice that I'm starting too far over to the right, so the more you capture, the better. And in this case, I'm actually twisting my body more than 90 degrees. And then you want to shoot a series of vertical shots. Believe it or not, that's going to give you the best results because you're going to have the most height information. And then just go ahead and take a bunch of images, try to keep the horizon flat as you do so, and make sure that you have at least a third overlap from one image to the next. As you can see in my case, I have more like a half overlap. And so once again, the more the better. And then finally, I'm going way too far over here to the left. And I believe at this point, if I press the right arrow key once again, well, I've got a little more imagery right there, and then I'll go ahead and cycle over to the far right-hand side. So again, I'm starting with my body twisting more than 90 degrees to the right, and then I'm ending with my body twisted more than 90 degrees to the left. All right, so assuming you've got all these raw images, I have 17 in all. I'll go ahead and press Control-A or Command-A on the Mac to select all of them, and then I'll go up to the Tools menu, choose Photoshop, and choose Photo Merge. And that's going to automatically switch you to Photoshop, as we're seeing here, and that'll bring up that same Photo Merge dialog box that we saw a moment ago. Which may make you think, well, why in the world is this approach so much better? Well, it goes ahead and automatically populates the file list right here. Then you want to turn on Blend Images Together. In our case, we're going to leave Vignette Removal and Geometric Distortion Correction turned off, because after all, I already compensated for the lens distortion inside Camera Raw before I saved off these JPEG files. If, however, you're working with JPEG files, then go ahead and turn both of these checkboxes on.